Hi, EJ. Michael from the Red Chair Diaries, Bedford, Nova Scotia, Canada. And I'm responding to your query for some video responses for the for your little contest there. Congratulations on amassing those viewers. And I would think that you're like me. You consider everyone precious, and each one of these viewers is worth 100 of the the viewers on some of the mega channels, right? Because sometimes I think small is beautiful. Anyway, I just wrote to you and told you that I would do this. I decided that I would try to do three movies from the year I was born, and since I seem to be one of the oldsters on this net, I was born in 1951, and the movies that I like best from that year are the ones that actually came out the year before, in 1950, and probably won the Oscar in the summer or the spring of 1951. But your contest is for the year I was born. Even though I was born December 51, I was 2 months premature, so I should have been born 52. You see how I can stretch it out so that it becomes more complicated? Sagittarius, I should be a Pisces. Oh, anyway, I digress. I've decided that I'm going to go... I had to go on IMDb, because where else am I going to find the list? And on page 1 for 1951, under Advanced Search, are two of the movies that I do really, really like. Day the Earth Stood Still. I mean, how could that not be one of my top three for that year? I mean, that I've actually seen. You should see some of the losers on that list of 1951 if you go far enough. But The Earth Stood Still, I've seen it many times. I saw it as a child, of course, because it was a staple of black and white television when we had black and white television then all the time. And it's not as much a staple now. It's more of probably a cult favorite now. Michael Rennie was wonderful. Michael Rennie, I know most from two things. One was his show The Third Man, which was the TV series version of the Third Man movie, and he was playing Harry Lime, though Harry Lime wasn't a crook anymore. He was just kind of like the saint, you know, kind of seemed to straddle two sides of the law, but people went to him for help. And people may not remember that show. I don't know how long it ran. It was a small black and white half-hour show. And Jonathan Harris, who went on to become Dr. Smith on Lost in Space, was his companion in crime, or companion in good deeds. So I remember Michael Rennie, and then the second time I remember him he was a guest star in every one of those Irwin Allen shows, Lost in Space, many times. He was the creepy keeper in the two-parter called The Keeper. I remember that so well. He was in, I think he was the captain of the Titanic on the time tunnel. He was, I assume he was in Land of the Giants. I don't remember for sure. And he was definitely in Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea. But to get back to the movie, The Earth Stood Still, I've always liked Michael Rennie. I like the premise of the movie, which is asking you to, or advising Earthlings, you know, not to go too far with the A-bomb sort of thing. And Patricia Neal, another one of my favorites, she was wonderful in that. I think Kent Smith was in that, who was in a lot of movies, I think, and I think he was a regular on the Time Tunnel as well, TV show. But it was a good movie. If it wasn't Kent Smith, it was, Jesus, you can't remember every name, can you? Oh, never mind, anyway. So I like that movie. Klaatu Narada Nictu, yes, something like that is the code word for the robot, right? Anyway. I'm amazed that I can jabberwalk so long, and I don't keep notes. It's all from my own 59-year-old brain. The other movie that I really liked that year was on that same page. My God, do I have it listed here? Let me see. I just said I'd do it all from memory. Yeah, Streetcar Named Desire was the second one. I think these were some of the most popular ones of that year. Streetcar Named Desire, of course, by Tennessee Williams. Interesting thing about that movie for me is I never saw that movie until I don't think 1975. I was in Boston, visiting in Boston, and I was walking down Boylston Street, and there was a double bill for a streetcar named Desire, Marlon Brando, and Last Tango in Paris. Now, please, who could resist? This is long before there were DVDs, and long before there were VHSs and things like that. And Last Tango in Paris had been banned in Nova Scotia, where I was living then. So that was an outrageous movie, right? You know, because of there was anal sex in it. I mean, Maria Scheider was being, you know, screwed by Marlon Brando, and he cries on the screen, and he's overweight, and you see his jiggly ass, and all of this sort of stuff. So, I mean, it was quite the movie. I think it's Bertolucci directed it. And I went from walking into, like, the middle of Streetcar Named Desire, or the last half hour, something like that. Saw the youthful, gorgeous Marlon Brando. And then I went into the next one where he was in his 40s. 25 years later. That's when it was photographed. That's quite a shock to the system, I can tell you. But anyway, Streetcar Named Desire. On the screen, of course, it's stagey, like all of his plays are when they're on the screen, because they are stage plays, and they try to expand them a bit, but there isn't much they can do with them. But I've read Tennessee Williams' autobiography, which he admits was mostly fiction, or was a lot of fiction. And I've read quite a bit, and I read a biography about Vivian Leigh and her manic depression and things like that. So, you know, their characters really resonated with me, you know, because I'd been reading things like that. Now, what else? The third one, good Lord, did I even come up with a third one? I think I decided to settle on the other one on the same page, because I don't like The African Queen, which is on this page, the number 5 movie, but I do like Strangers on a Train, which is a Hitchcock movie. And I've seen that one a few times. I have that one on Laserdisc. I do not own The African Queen. I own an autobiography or a memoir by Katharine Hepburn about making that movie, but I never cared for the movie. I've never been the biggest Bogart fan, I guess, either. So, Strangers on a Train is where the phrase thing crisscross comes from, and it was mocked. There was a parody of it, basically, by Danny DeVito in the 80s called Throw Mama from the Train. But it's the story where two strangers meet and they end up deciding that they enter an agreement where they'll kill the person that the other person's trying to get rid of, and there's no connection between them. Anyway, it's a wonderful, wonderful movie. I think it's black and white, but we have the laser disc of that. And I think that's about it. I think I've done more than enough jibber jabber here, and I should let you get back to your work. It's Michael from the Red Chair Diaries, and I hope everybody watching also subscribes to me, to my channel, the Red Chair Diaries. I have a lot of variety on there, you know, book reviews, movie reviews, political commentaries, gay commentaries, being a gay man myself, but it's not a gay channel as far as that goes. But I'd like to warn people in case, you know, I don't want fundamentalist Christians being terribly upset with me or something. Anyway, that's about it for now, okay? And we'll see you around the net. And don't eat anything bigger than your head, as B. Kleban says.